Do you wish that you could go viral on Pinterest? Do you wonder what's the secret to creating viral Pinterest pins? How do you get noticed? Do you wish that you could get thousands of clicks to your blog or website from Pinterest traffic? So, hey, bosses, I'm Natalie Bardo, your Pinterest coach. And a few days ago, I went viral. It was amazing. It's not the first time that I've gone viral. To be honest, it happens around 5 times every year, like clockwork, because of some of the secrets I'm going to share with you in this video. But here's a look at what happened. It was amazing. 10,000 clicks from Pinterest in 1 day. So, in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you some of the results that I've received from going viral. With the last two examples in the few months that this happened, I'm going to show you the stats, the clicks, everything I learned. Then I'm going to reverse engineer the process so that you too can go viral on Pinterest. So let's get started. But first, I invite you to like this video if you love Pinterest tips. And don't forget to subscribe because I've got weekly videos just like this coming your way each and every week. So, what does it mean to go viral? Like, if you go viral on Pinterest, what does that actually look like? So, when you go viral, that means there's a massive jump in saves or repins on your pins, but also clicks, where it's all about those outbound clicks to your website. So, when you go viral, to me, that's at least a 10 times increase. So, if you usually get 100 clicks, there's 1,000 clicks, or I could say at the minimum 10 times, but truly going viral is like 100 times what is usual. You're gonna get a huge jump in traffic to your site, a huge jump in sales or ad income, or a huge jump on your subscriber list. So it's a day where you've got a huge spike. The truth about going viral is that it's unusual. You know, it doesn't happen every day. It's not the bread and butter of your Pinterest strategy. We don't set goals to go viral. It just happens. It's one of those, you know, pleasant surprises. You wake up and you're like, oh my gosh, it's so great. Because the truth about going viral is that think about any viral video that's happened. That person goes viral for a day, 2 days, but at most a week, and then everything goes back to usual. And it's the same with going viral on Pinterest. The key ingredient to going viral is that it's organic. That means it's not paid, it just happens. You create a piece of content that pinners are just genuinely interested in. They gravitate towards it, they are repinning it, they are clicking on it, and the Pinterest algorithm picks up on that and shows it to even more pinners who are interested in the content that you're creating. And that's what just happened for me. So, to begin, let's take a look at actually what happened when I went viral. All right, so this is right on the Pinterest site. I wanted to focus on the last 2 times I went viral. So we can see here it was on New Year's Eve, the best day for traffic for my site, and most recently, Monday that just passed. Amazing, right? So over on my analytics, you can see that I've got some huge spikes and then some little baby spikes in my traffic. These are all days where I had a pin that took off and I went viral. So here are those 2 days I mentioned to you, the last 2 times that I went viral on Pinterest. And I want to show you what happens so that you can understand what it means for your traffic, your sales, and your subscribers. So on that first day, we can see I had a massive jump up to 15 million impressions. Crazy, right? When I take a deeper look at this, I told you guys, I investigated so you can know how you can go viral too on Pinterest. The one thing I want you to grab your attention to is to notice that most of these pins, it's a group of pins that go viral at the same time. We have one with 5,600 clicks, another one with 3,300 clicks, and so on and so forth. But most were saved by other pinners. Isn't that interesting? We can see also on the day, the same spike could be seen in Mediavine, which is where I get my ad income from. I made 566 just on this 1 day. Isn't that awesome? It was a really great day. Like I said, icing on the cake doesn't keep the lights on, but it could help you buy yourself something nice unexpectedly, right? And the same thing is true for my email list. I got 200 subscribers in that day alone. We can see that this spike ripples across traffic, sales, and subscribers, as well as income. So on this day, which just happened this week, we can see I had a massive jump. So if you've been following along, I told you I had 16 million views, then 6 million views. Now I'm back up to over 10 million. Pinterest analytics impressions don't really matter that much. It really fluctuates seasonally and in terms of pins taking off, right? So we can see here 10,000 clicks in one day. So we can also see the similar thing as before. It's a group of pins that take off together, one with 4,000, none with 3,000 clicks, and so on and so forth. And together, that's how my content goes viral on Pinterest, not just one pin. So we can also see that I made $311 on Mediavine in that day alone while my content went viral. So remember, when your content goes viral, you're gonna get a huge boost in traffic, in subscribers, in sales or ad revenue. It's the icing on the cake, but it is not the cake itself. I need you to remember that. There are no guarantees in terms of going viral. It's like a nice bonus. So I want you to get your head around that. But remember, when you follow the strategies I'm going to teach you right now, you have an increased chance or odd or opportunity to go viral, because I count on my content going viral at least 3 to 5 times a year. And this strategy helps me to achieve that. So this is how you can go viral on Pinterest or create Pinterest pins that go viral. So number one, you've got to be consistent on Pinterest. And this is super important, especially if you're brand new to the platform and you're like, oh man, I got to go viral. We're all, you know, obsessed with going viral. But I want you to remember that going viral is not like the be all and end all of Pinterest strategy. Because you haven't gone viral, it doesn't mean that you're a failure. Going viral is just this thing that happens. It doesn't mean that you're failing. So keep that in mind. But you've got to be consistent on Pinterest. That means you're pinning a consistent amount of pins each and every day, whether that's 5 pins or 15 pins, whatever is doable for you, make sure you keep doing it, that you are being consistent. It's so important to have a presence on Pinterest and know that not 100% of your pins are going to go viral or even get any attention. Maybe 1% does, but what 1% of nothing is still nothing. So you want to make sure that you've got more, you know, cards in the game. You've got a chance to actually win at this. So be consistent. I have a whole video about that. I'll link to it below if you want to know how you can become consistent. The second thing I want you to do is to figure out what people are actually interested in visually. So what pin designs are getting action? What pin designs are people clicking on? What pin designs are people engaging with? You've got to look at the visuals and figure out, okay, if I've got all of these designs, 1 through 5, and you know only 3 is the one that's getting action, then you're more likely to get a viral pin using that winning design. So how do you figure that out? So I wanted to reverse engineer this whole process. So we're using Carly of 52 Cities account to show you how you figure out what are those designs that are going to have the best chance of going viral on Pinterest. So you're going to click on analytics and head to overview. The one thing I want to encourage you to do is to make sure that you're actually just looking at the stats to your domain, not to your whole profile. So we're going to click on our domain right here. I've got 52 Cities on the left-hand side. So we're just seeing stats for your site, but we're going to scroll down to the bottom and I want you to click where it says top pins, select outbound clicks. I don't really care about impressions. I'm all about the clicks. To me, that's the proof of going viral. So we can see here that these are all of Carly's top pins. So you're going to do the same. Click on them or you can hover over and it's going to preview the designs. So I can see right away that her top winning design is this collage style pin with the white, you know, object in the middle with the title. So let's go back. I'm scrolling down, collage pin, here, 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 here. So 8 out of 10 of Carly's top pins right now use the collage pin style. So if she wants to go viral, her best chance is going to be with this design. So what is your best performing design? You can also look at the types of content. What types of your content are doing well? Is it travel guides? Is it, you know, tip and checklist? Carly's a travel blogger. That's why my examples are travel related. So I'm going to, if I was Carly, to create some viral pins, you're going to look at what are these travel topics that are trending right now. So we know she's being consistent. One, done. We know the type of style of pin that is most popular. It's the collage pin. And third is we need to figure out what are those seasonal and trending content. Because if we're going to go viral on Pinterest, it's all about being seasonal or creating that timely content. What are people interested in right now and coming up? That brings me to my next tip. You're going to create seasonal content for 60 days out. Because you want to make sure that you have enough time for those pins to take off. Because if you've been pinning, you may notice that it takes a while. A lot of your pins have zero engagement when you first pin them. So you cannot. So say, for example, it's Halloween. You can't pin on October 31st. You got to back it up 60 days. So that takes you to the end of August, beginning of September. That's when you're going to put out the content. So you're giving it time to take off. So how do you know what that content should be about? Simple. Let me show you. I feel like I'm always talking about it, but it's Pinterest trends. So click on analytics, click on trends. It's showing what's trending right now. So if she's a travel blogger, I'm actually just going to put in travel and see what comes up. Automatically, you can see these trending graphs. So you want to choose a topic that is going uphill. So we can see here, travel hacks is on a rebound, but travel quotes is going down. So we're not going to create content on that right now. So I'm actually going to click on travel outfits plane, and we can see in the last year, it's on an uptrend, and we want to start to think seasonally as well. So I'm going to put in this one for winter so I can show you the power of thinking seasonally. Clearly, winter is on the way out, spring is coming. So the part of time where you would create this content is November to the beginning of January. That's when people would be interested, and then this piece of content is no longer of importance. So let's actually put in summer. This is a great way for you to see the contrast of seasons. So from May to late September, people are curious in summer outfits. And then naturally, they start thinking about winter outfits. So if you created content for summer and winter, you are more likely to get a spike at both of those times, as opposed to just having a generic article on outfits in general. So when you're planning seasonal viral pins, remember, your evergreen content, that's content that isn't tied to a season, a holiday, or a celebration, that's the baseline. But you want to get those spikes in your traffic that's going to pull it up and have those amazing days. And that's what pinning to seasonal topics, holidays, celebrations, festivities, there are so many, tie your content to them. Your business blogger, for example, how about you give tips on how to launch a business or how to do summer promotions, how to do winter promotions, how to do St. Patrick's Day promotions, how to do Halloween promotions, whatever. Pick the holiday and celebration or the season and tack it on to whatever it is, the type of content you create. And remember, when you're creating those seasonal pins, you're doing your pin SEO. You're adding in the keywords in all the right places. I have a whole video on that. Click the link in the description and you can figure out how to start pin SEOing your pins. Your next strategy is you're going to share that content in Tailwind communities and in Facebook groups to get other pinners to save it to their profiles. This is so key. Like I told you, all my viral pins were saved by other people. They were pins that I designed eons ago. Okay, 3 years ago, 2 years ago, that they saved recently, and then it takes off. So you can help that process along. This is the part where you have control. By sharing to Tailwind communities, other users are going to share your pins to their profiles, increasing the odds of it taking off. So this is inside a Tailwind community. And it's a place for reciprocity, meaning I'm adding a pin and then saving another pin by someone else who's added a pin. So by doing that, you're increasing the chances of getting repins. Not all communities are the best, but there are some really great ones that are going to get you repins. So say, for example, this is one of my Tailwind communities and I've had 3,000 reshares by other users. That is so incredible. This is just one. I belong to many, many Tailwind communities. So be sure to click my link and claim your free trial to Tailwind so you can start using communities. If you request to join my group boards, I can also add you to my own Tailwind communities that I carefully monitor so that you can also get those reshares. And remember, you want to start doing this 60 days out if possible, if not 30 days. So be sure to budget time for that. It's all about getting those shares by relevant users. Okay, the last tip I have for you is don't panic. Be patient. It can take time. It's not going to happen overnight. Sure, it can happen overnight, but those are the rare once in a blue moon, wish upon a star type of instances. You're not going to go viral overnight. It can take weeks, months, or dare I say, even years. Like I showed you, the pins that go viral for me on a yearly basis, using my seasonal content strategy that I just shared with you, they are shared in 2018, 2019, but I'm constantly adding new pins. So when that season is coming up 60 days out, I'm already planning new pins. And those pins do get clicks, but it doesn't always compare to some of the older ones that I shared in the past. So it's not about me pinning those older pins. It's me adding those into Tailwind Tribes and somebody else saving it that's telling Pinterest, oh, this pin is getting engagement and more people are clicking on it and saving it. So the algorithm kicks in, algorithms are good, helping your pin to be seen by more people who are gonna click on it. And that's how you end up with a day like I did where I got 10,000 clicks in one day. So if you loved these tips and you're ready to go viral on Pinterest, be sure to like this video and comment down below with any questions or comments you might have. And of course, subscribe to my channel because I've got more Pinterest tips coming your way each and every week.